I can never leave Clara's groups. They're too entertaining.
And it's very, very
Who's
good to
this?
start our conversation. That's why probably
Someone
I chose
added
it.
here, me
That
here.
to think about what
Gabrielle.
really does matter and what really, I mean, gives the starting value. Obviously, not, as was mentioned now, very little, like microscopical part of the society is able to have access to haute couture.
Those that I can't
to touch
have
it,
links
wear it, and so on.
To.
But all of us,
I don't think I'm
going to
leave yet.
We have access to see it. And we see it at least online, and we can get inspired for everyday work, for our companies, for everything that we do. I don't think that it's important to have it personally in your wardrobe to be able to be inspired.
But I love the bells ringing in the background. Oh, where are you right now located?
As I said in the beginning, I don't have at all telephone connection at home because my apartment in Florence is such an antique building.
We're in this like completely useless space on Twitter. I don't even go there. I don't know why I'm there. Just to get an update from myself on what is going on with the conversations around fashion these days. But honestly, it's boring and not even entertaining. You know what I mean? Like, they're supposed to be at least entertaining, if not educating. But here we are.
With a girl, forgot the name. And this floor is like a square, and she's like looking from out the window and standing there. Basically, Maria is living there, and she sees that square every day from her window. So, do you guys know that from Scratch series?
So sad this is happening still.
Show in Chicago for apparel. Just got back late last night and actually got the opportunity to speak with a number of brands that I've kind of been connected to over the years about what we're currently doing. And I can say that I was overwhelmed by the interest, which was different from last year when I attended some of the shows and was talking about kind of Web3 and the link between the physical and digital and the things that you could do. So I will just sit in the background. I see Callie's got her hand up. You can see her and then Lou and Remix and Paul Dress. So apologies for being late, but I am here.
Don't worry, we saved you a glass of Prosecco.
Yeah, and you did not hear that this year we're learning Italian, so please sign up for courses if you want.
So next year is Russian.
Joining us because we're going to have them in Italian.
And I know you probably think I'm kidding, but I'm going to try to show up so you can say some words. Let's go.
Okay, Kelly, you had your hand up for quite a bit.
Seven words a week is sounds more my speed, and I also forgot when we were talking to all non-native English speakers, so yeah, I'm really out of my league. I took 13 years of Spanish and can't speak any of it, so I'm going to do better this time.
Maybe you have better luck.
Yeah, exactly, and I'm sure it won't be heavily biased towards fashion at all. No, it'll actually probably help us remember. But yeah, anyways, my question to fashion, not going to get us derailed, it usually it's my fault. I'm curious as to how haute couture, because it sounds very similar to just the highest end of fine art, right? There's very little supply, very little
Never leave.
Consumers.
Buja.
And it's also one of, best investments from a appreciation standpoint over, I think it's 5 to 10 years. It's crazy.
see how a post-couture brand is actually creating a piece. Before,
this guy's working so hard. Bot, okay, it's bot. But still, he works so hard.
The one, for example, hosted Milan on a yearly basis. Speaking about transparency from luxury,
Too many Metaslavic ones and too little internationals, unless they're like Web3. What is this? Somebody added this to me, I don't even remember. It's quite interesting. There's a lot of value in many of them, it's just too much noise still. Rebranding Canal. Ah, поэтому there was a rebranding. W3. But I'm sorry, I can't do this, this is too much. Where is Link? Oh, I love Synergy so much. Such good links. Twitter Spaces kind of not wanting us to hear them. You know, we produce too much. All of us. Humans guy is not really friendly, human, so I'm just saying. It's just, you know, was willing to meet and then canceled both meetings. I try to be nice, my loves, but like when you cancel, like, you know, and just you know, you're just not nice. And how can you lead like an HR / human connection firm and not be nice? That's why I kind of left the idea of being an HR at this point, because I can't pretend that I'm interested in you if I'm not. And remember, I have multiple Telegram accounts, so this is just the first one that I'm checking. Reload that space.
Product, right? So there's like a few products there that people were showing, you know, it's like, what do you get for the person who has everything was kind of the theme. So yeah,
the golden pool.
Oh my god. And I was talking like sincerely and so seriously about reconsidering values in life and our society, like seriously, I was giving all that speech.
I think, you know, the idea is that it's humor, it's a satire, it's a satirical joke, it's kind of making a joke on wealth. It's really, if you look a little bit more deeply, it is supposed to be a satirical, there's a satirical point there. That's kind of pointing to the ridiculousness of great wealth.
No, I'm joking myself. The world is full of crazy things. So, I mean, all good. No offense.
I mean, it's still hilarious. But it is also what I said. There is that, you know, it's a satirical statement. But when I saw it, I couldn't believe it. It was like, yeah, pretty funny. But there it is.
Where do you buy these? Asking for a friend.
I only saw it mentioned in a magazine aside from this party, but you probably could get it online, probably.
Maximilian will hook you up.
I was going to say, Kelly, yeah. You're going to be the officially friend.
You know what I can say?
We'll
I think we just missed each other, and we cannot have a normal conversation because we are just adding these weird facts into this conversation that was supposed to be a serious topic about high fashion. So I feel like this is the most gathering after a long time.
James, you have something to add to
this? I think I can give us a pivot. As much as I want to talk about golden pivots, it probably would be wise to... somebody has texted me, and apparently Hermes has won the case against Rothschild in terms of the trademark infringement on Birkin. So I guess that's kind of breaking. But yeah, pretty awesome to know that we can usher. posturing the brands, without them having to worry about infringement and all those other things. And I was curious to see how this case would play out.
That was so quick. I saw it last week that they go into court, or maybe 2 weeks ago. But it's over. They won so fast.
Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what. Maybe they came to some sort of arrangement.
Writing recently. In any case, they were the first designer from the ready-to-wear world to join the haute couture, and this year their collection was just so incredible. I generally like the style, and this year it was particularly really good, so I recommend everybody to have a look at it. I can maybe send the pictures under the comments of this space right now.
Yes, please do. I will also open it to have a look as we speak.
Actually, I'm a little bit surprised that we start with new layer, because it's not really like world, maybe world known because of her fun, but because of high fashion, it's not really. And people just have the idea of the stockings and tights that celebrities are wearing, but they don't understand the history behind this brand. Revolutionary impact in the fashion world. And yes, the latest collection I actually really, really loved. And I showed it to my students also as a great, great example of multidisciplinary work of art. I don't know if I pronounce it well in English, but I mean, that fashion show, the choreography, the sound, the whole production work behind. It was art. Clothes were just part of it. It was not only about clothing. It was about the whole, like a theater performance. So this is what is really, really, really interesting. And I would really consider worth watching not only photos, but the videos from this show. Because it's amazing. It's a work of art in terms of choreography, scenography, and so many, many, many other parts of the cultural industry. Please watch it because it's such a good example of how wide is the spectrum of fashion shows as part of art.
I also saw that many like supermodels from, you know, way back were in the show as well, so that's really awesome to see as well.
I didn't want to interrupt, but I needed to. So I wanted just to say thank you, everybody. It was a real pleasure to digitally talk to you, and hope to see you really soon in Italy, speaking Italian. Please don't forget, next time we all meet physically, you have to speak Italian or Spanish as well.
I'll be working on it. It's always good to hear your voice, Rana.
Oh, well, Maximilian, yours too. Thank you.
I'm ready. I'm waiting. Thank you so much for your input today. Thank you.
Don't go. Oh, we have a call with a glass of milk, okay?
Yep, and
bye.
Don't forget
bye, everyone. Bye.
Okay, anyone else have any moments that you would like to share with us that, you know, you have kind of stuck in your memory from this year so far?
Hi, friends. I
actually want to twist that question a little bit and ask what you all think about Doja Cat's look, because that took over social media.
There is silence, like literally nobody wants to talk about Schiaparelli.
That's why I kind of want to know, because I don't know, like personally, I just think I don't get the social media.
Really?
Maria, I think you cannot hear, there's someone speaking.
No, actually, I was very intrigued with that collection. We are talking about...
Maria, sorry, we had a question. I think you did not hear it. Maybe you rubbed or something. Crown Studio was supposed to speaking.
Sorry.
It was about Doja's cat look, which blew the internet. What do you guys think?
What are some...
Oh, you mean the people that are coming as guests?
Yeah. You know the red outfit that Doja Cat.
Yes, of course. It's 30,000 Swarovskis attached to her head and neck. Yes. So I hated the boots. I loved the Swarovskis.
But I mean, at the same time, like yes, it's definitely impressive and definitely took a lot of time. But does it push? Like, does it show you something creative? I don't
understand. Do you have a problem with internet? I can't hear you.
Maria, can you try leaving and coming back to the space if you don't mind? Because you seem to have some technical issue here. Okay, thanks. No, I agree with Brown Studios. For me, I don't know, I was not impressed. I don't know, I don't see the creativity.
I mean, it was more about, it was more about shock
value
exactly.
Or something.
Like, it had nothing really to do with fashion, in my opinion. More of, yes, it took a lot of time. Yes, it's impressive to have 30,000 Swarovskis on you, and I can imagine it's very stressful to wear that. I would not sign up for something like that, personally. But at the same time, where is the creativity here? You know, that's kind of my thought.
What does anyone else think? Maximilian, what do you think?
I prefer fashion that I feel like no matter how outrageous it is that someone could wear, I feel like if it really isn't wearable, and when I say this, I mean like, so I'm an entertainer, even though you probably just know me as an artist, fashion designer, but I spend usually a lot of time performing on stages, so when I say someone could wear, I mean like, for a performance even, you know, which is not the same kind of clothes you would wear to a party. So I still consider that like wearable. So like for me, if someone couldn't wear it even as a stage performance, it should belong into maybe a visual art form. I know that in the past there's been like shows where forgive me, but who is it that made the dresses that was really like another person's body upside down with the butt in the face? Like, to me, that was not fashion. To me, that was like a making a statement. And again, kind of like the poo capsules, you know, making a satirical comment on fashion as opposed to actually making fashion itself. And to me, I don't particularly appreciate that. It feels... it doesn't feel exploratory and experimental. It feels cheeky.
Yeah, that's what Victor and Rolf is for. Hello?
Visual that we use for our banner today. Maria, can you hear us? All good?
I have no idea. I thought that I was connected before, and I wasn't. So again, I have issues, but I'm sorry. This is the favorite part of the topic, and I'm losing it, and I am so, so, so sorry, because I wanted to... hear your opinion on these topics, on these brands, and especially I heard a part now about Victor and Rolf, and actually as not being wearable, I don't think that the fashion in general. Do you hear me? I'm now worried.
Yep.
Yes. Absolutely. No, I mean that I don't think that fashion has to be wearable all the time. I think that fashion as the form of art can be, first of all, of course, can be high fashion, can be wearable fashion, but can be also as an installation. It can be like a painting. It's like, it's, or, I don't know, or for example, performance art. Performance art is just the moment. So if you watch it,
just highlight Amfedine Alaya and those of you that are coming for Pirate NFT. He has the foundation of his brand. There's a nice setup, there's a nice space where they actually have the whole history. And to me, apart from the library, which is obviously amazing, how it ties all the, you know, with the art and all the books happening in her social hemisphere. But I feel as Amfedine is something very interesting because of what we're talking about, of how long it takes, just the craftsmanship and the skills that is needed. Basically, and it's something that I didn't know until I visited this installation, is that, you know, brilliant works like the Mondrian, like Yves Saint Laurent, and several of the Dior dresses, and, you know, many like Thierry Mugler and some of the others that we, you know, now highlight as, you know, one of the masters of prostitution. Like, he was the one behind the construction of those and the idea of those. So not only, you know, how it is, you know, what is it that we want to present, but how is it that we actually, like, the execution, and he was the one that made it work, that those dresses became so famous, historic, and I just, like, I, you know, if anybody's here, definitely visit that installation, because it's amazing, of all the things that he has done for haute couture and fashion overall.
Can I ask, did you speak already about Gabrielli when I was gone, or not yet?
No, I wanted this to go to you, but Ella, thanks so much for sharing. We'll definitely, everyone, be sure to check it out. Maria, is your time to shine on Schiaparelli?
No, it's not about shining. It's actually very, very interesting because the day after, I got a call from a journalist at like 8 in the morning, insanely early, and she was like, oh my God, the world is traumatized about this collection. What do you think about it? We want to make an article. We need your opinion, and so on and so on. And I had this conversation with this person for like an hour, and all of this time, I felt that she's disappointed about my answers. But she was actually expecting some kind of like disgust in that collection, and I don't know. She was hoping that I would say that it's horrible. First of all, I think that in general, the public understands things in certain ways.
Sorry, Максим, я даже не буду тебя добавлять в мой списочек. Максим is just super triggering for me, and I've known him for so many years.